It's Quinn and Cantara.
It is Pix 106. We welcome on our weekly guest. It is Paul Harding from Martin Harding and Mazzotti. Reach him at 1-800-LAW-1010, 1-800-LAW-1010. How you doing, Paul?
Good morning, guys. Doing well.
Paul, we got this story yesterday. An Arkansas woman cashed a $1 million lottery ticket. Now, here's the deal. She picked it out of the garbage. Now, someone else won it, I guess scanned it. It didn't come up as a winner, and she threw it away. And this other woman picked it out of a garbage can and won it, and then went and spent some of the $1 million.
Right.
And we thought to ourselves, well, we got to ask Paul Harding about this one. what is the legality here? There's all sorts of burden of proof stuff going on.
Yeah, it turned out the woman who found the ticket was out there looking for tickets, because in Arkansas, this took place. Apparently, you find these old abandoned tickets, and if you put them in the lottery system, you get points. And eventually, if you have enough points, you get a prize. So when she went submit that to the lottery, they said not only are you going to get 1 point, it's worth $1 million. So, yeah, she thought she won. She wasn't shy about it. Lo and behold, it was the owner of the store who actually sued her and said, hey, wait, that was in my garbage.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
That was in my garbage.
So the owner of the store didn't have the winning ticket either?
No, because the owner of the store just sold the ticket and claimed it was in my garbage, and therefore it's my ticket. And the woman who actually bought the ticket, she didn't do anything for a while. She just kind of found out what was going on. Eventually, someone contacted her and said, hey, we think this is the ticket you threw out. So just confusion, and everybody thought they had a right to this ticket.
Here's my question. So it's true that the woman who initially owned the ticket scanned it and it showed up not a winner?
Correct.
Can she get her cash from the lotto or from the people who make the scanner for faulty scanning?
Yeah, no, that was never looked at. I think that there's an argument that the faulty scanning took place, and again, I took a look at this again this morning. It was a scratch-off ticket, and she hadn't scratched everything off, so she didn't even prepare the ticket properly.
Uh-huh.
To put under the scanner for the scanner to improperly tell her it was.
Well, that's her own damn fault.
Correct. Right.
So Paul, you're going to rule on this case. Who gets the money here?
Well, you know, I think that what seems the most fair would have been there's some kind of a deal cut, some kind of a settlement here. The two of them should have gotten together, the one who found the ticket and the one who purchased the ticket. And of course, that's not what did happen. It's the person who purchased the ticket.
Doesn't that set a precedent, though, for other issues when you have all these lotto issues? Like, oh, well, let's give half to one person, half to the other person, because the other one found it, but it was originally the other, you know what I mean? Because then next time this happens, there's a precedent in law, which is, one of those things, in the legal world that is just really important, right?
Yeah, it is. And the judge had to make a decision. It was probably a tough one. But the question came down to, was the property abandoned? Meaning, if we lose or abandon property, it could be your sunglasses, your cell phone. At what point can someone else find it and have it be theirs? In New York State, what we have to do is we find property that's not ours and we don't know who owns it. We're supposed to take it to the police department, register ourselves as the person who found it, and 3 years later it becomes ours if nobody claims it. So that really was the legal question was, did she abandon the property? And the judge found that she did not.
It is Quinn and Cantara, Pix 106. We're talking to Paul Harding from Martin Harding and Mazzotti. Talk to him at 1-800-LAW-1010, 1-800-LAW-1010. Really quickly, and this might be a curveball, but I'm just curious, and clearly this is wide open, but when you play in the NFL, by agreeing to play in the NFL, are you accepting the potential harm that could come to you a la a form of brain damage?
Yeah, absolutely. That's what's happening with these folks. Again, disability insurance policies are mandated by the NFL. You also have a scenario where they have a version of a workers' compensation law, so you continue to get funds if you are found to be disabled. And, of course, most of these guys, after a 5 or 10 year career, if they last that long, have some disability.
Well, sir, we certainly appreciate your time. It's Paul Harding from Martin Harding and Mazzotti, 1-800-LAW-1010. You can call him 24 hours a day, 1-800-LAW-1010. Thanks again, sir.
Okay, guys, thank you.